Yeah, the candidates are still crisscrossing the state on this caucus eve, courting all those undecided voters who will be making the difference in the tight races on both sides. As a matter of fact, Edwards, I understand, 36 hours in a row he's going to be campaigning. Steve Handelsman now has the latest in Des Moines.
John McCain changed plans and headed to Iowa after the respected Iowa poll showed him surging to third among Republicans. In an internet ad, McCain hammers a chief rival.
Mitt Romney says the next president doesn't need foreign policy experience.
Romney is reacting.
I think I fit the bill.
Mike Huckabee's making excuses in case he loses Iowa.
I know we've been outspent 20-1.
Iowan Bill Hilliard has quit shopping for a candidate. McCain is his man.
I think he would be able to unite the Democrats and Republicans more than most of them will.
Iowa political scientist Dennis Goldfuss says McCain's dream scenario is to derail Romney tomorrow.
McCain's interest, like that of Giuliani, is to make sure nobody, particularly Governor Romney, comes barreling out of Iowa as the predominant front runner.
Thanks for having us.
On the Democratic side, John Edwards is on a 36-hour no-sleep caucus push. He has less cash than his rivals after Iowa, so for Edwards, the caucuses are must-win. Hillary Clinton's running a final ad touting her experience.
Who's ready to be president?
Barack Obama's counting on first-time voters.
Is everybody going to caucus?
Democrat Nan Valentine says she will go, but is still undecided.
I'm really torn still between Hillary Clinton, Obama, and also John Edwards.
Meanwhile, Iowa's cold snap is breaking, which could help turnout.
And that could affect who wins. The experts here say better weather means more first-timers will show up. The polls here indicate that they tend to favor Obama and Huckabee. From caucus headquarters in Des Moines, I'm Steve Handelsman. KCRA3 reports.
Well, some of the polls indicate that. They're all over the place. Meantime, California voters will be heading off to the polls just over a month from now.
But absentee voters will be seeing their ballots in the mail next week, just as the results are being tallied in New Hampshire. KCRA3 political reporter Kevin Riggs is here with more on election preps in full spring. Kevin?
Lois and Dave, time is in fact short for county election workers who face the earliest primary California has ever held. In fact, some overseas ballots have already been returned.
It's not exactly Christmas in January, but county election workers are scrambling to open box after box.
Make sure there's no errors and count the ballots in the box. And then when you're done, put a check mark and set the boxes right here.
Stacks of ballots fresh from the printer. It's just the start of an unusual and unprecedented election year rush.
It is just like the waves keep coming in one election right after another, and they're really on top of each other, preparing for one while we are finishing up another one.
With primaries in February and June and a general election in November, counties are gearing up, assigning precincts, hiring poll workers, assembling precinct supply kits. Sacramento County alone expects to hire up to 200 temporary workers.
Everything from ballot checking, proofing, quality control, I mean, helping with verify signatures, all those types of jobs will need to be done here.
These are just some of the absentee ballots that will be hitting mailboxes beginning early next week. Locally, as well as statewide, the trend is going up in terms of voting by mail in excess of 50%. Those ballots are being proofread for errors before going in the mail. The last day to request a ballot by mail is January 29th, but voters can't wait too long to mail them back.
We do not accept postmarked ballots, so on election day we will take a sweep through the post office, make sure that all the ballots are picked up. But if we receive your ballot after election day, it will not be counted.
With complex procedures and multiple deadlines, counties are launching an electoral marathon in 2008.
Keep running. Just keep going. We'll make it to the finish line.
And yes, in fact, this extra election next month is expected to cost about $90 million statewide. And again, voting by mail is expected to be an increasingly popular option.
And Kevin, you are off to New Hampshire, I understand.
Packing for New Hampshire, pundits will tell you that whoever wins at Iowa enjoys a real slingshot effect heading into New Hampshire. So, for example, if Mitt Romney doesn't do well in Iowa or Hillary Clinton doesn't do well in Iowa, then they have to do very well in New Hampshire. So here's a new poll that was just out today that shows you just how tight the race is in New Hampshire. You can see this poll done by CNN and our affiliate WMUR in Manchester. It shows a very tight race on both sides. The Democratic side, Hillary Clinton, 34%, you can see there. Obama,
30%, and Edwards trailing by 17%. Even tighter on the Republican side. Take a look at this. Mitt Romney, 29%, tied with John McCain at 29%. You'll recall McCain won the primary there in 2000 over George W. Bush, and Giuliani trailing by 12%. So these races all over the board, extremely tight, and because they're tight, some people are saying it may make the California vote even more important on February 5th.
Yeah, these polls are shifting on a daily basis, it would appear. Now on to Iowa. And I think what may impress or distract a lot of people, not that many people actually involved in the voting process in Iowa. And it's not like going to the polls. It's a very complicated Byzantine caucus session they get into.
Yeah, and it's hard to understand those caucuses because the rules are so strange and so complicated. But you're right, it's a complicated situation, and people might get the idea that all of Iowa is really involved with this, that they kick the tires and check under the hood for these candidates. But it really is, I think, about 6% or so of voters who actually show up at these caucuses. So it's a very small amount, even for a state a small size as Iowa is.
Yeah, I know a lot of correspondents are trying to find Iowans to talk about the case. Yeah. They don't appear to be interested.
Yeah, it's sort of a myth that Iowa is as involved as people say it is.
All right.
More reporters there.
Good luck in New Hampshire.
Thank you.
Bring your jackets.
Woolies.
Yeah, I hear you. All right. Now, how interested are you in the Iowa caucuses? In our KCRA.com survey, we ask you the importance of the outcome of the Iowa caucuses. Very important, somewhat important. I don't care. As you can see the results right now, overwhelming majority just don't really give a hoot. And you can still log on to KCRA.com and share your thoughts with us. You can also send us an email through a link in the results section of that survey.
Some emails. Jerry sent us this. He says, why should anyone get excited about a few activists conducting a group encounter that intimidates attendees?
And in El Dorado County, Steve writes, I hate to break it to you, fine people of Iowa, but the Iowa caucuses are no longer relevant, if they ever were. Thanks for writing us. We'll have more of your emails and poll results later on.